Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session we will see this induction cooker. If you have problem in the power supply section, that is low voltage power supply, how we can troubleshoot it. Basically it is a working unit. It is a good working unit. The reason behind this video that I received a message on my WhatsApp from Germany. Our friend, he wrote that he have problem in this cooker. He said he is receiving 3 volt in this power supply. It is not providing 5 volt. So let's check what are the test points for the power supply. Let me remove all other items, then we will check step by step. And be sure that this is unisolated circuit. Live electrical voltage are present here. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair, never touch any component when the power is applied, because it is very dangerous. We will see the circuit and then we will see the troubleshooting checkpoints, how we can test it. This circuit have 2 different portions. The one portion that is high power rail, that will drive this magnetic coil, resonant coil. It will receive direct voltage from the line voltage and bridge rectifier will rectify. These voltage will reach here and IGBT will switch between the ground and the positive side and it will make pulses in the magnetic coil. To drive this IGBT and to power up the other circuit, we need VCC voltage. And to drive the IGBT gate drive network, we need high voltage, that are 18 volt. Here we need 5 volt VCC voltage for the microcontroller. To power up this circuit, 18 volt and 5 volt, we need this power supply section. If we have something wrong here, what will happen? It will not power up the circuit. Even if you connect the front panel, if you connect all the circuit, if the VCC voltage are not good, if these are low, the circuit will not turn on properly. It will give some dimmy beep. The beep will not too strong like here. Let me connect power. This time I removed everything, just only I am connecting this magnetic coil and we will check the beep. This is the good beep. If this beep is very dim, at that time we must understand that there is a problem in this low voltage power supply. If you see the circuit configuration, let me explain in some blocks. We have line voltage. Here we have bridge rectifier. Then we have a capacitor here. That is charging capacitor. That is here. Bridge rectifier is under this heatsink here. And IGBT is also there. Here we have a capacitor. From this point, we have a coil. And here we have IGBT. When it will receive pulse here from the gate drive components that are here, it will switch and it will pass these positive voltage to the coil and then it will turn off. When it will turn off, this magnetic field will cause to charge this capacitor. And then this capacitor will build specific voltage, then it will discharge again in the winding. So this machine uses this resonant frequency to make a tank circuit. To operate gate drive, we need some voltage here. In some cookers, some magnetic stoves, that is using transformer based power supply. Some transformer, then it have rectifier, and then capacitor and some voltage regulator, that is provided to next circuit. But in this circuit, this Chinese board, it is KYH19T-2. This board, it is using standalone SMPS circuit. Sometime it is using Viper IC, TNY, LNK, like that, SDC. So it is an isolated buck regulator. It will use this voltage here. Here it will charge at, we can say 330 volt, 310 volt DC. And then it will make voltage from this 18 volt and approximately 9 to 10 volt, 8 volt. These 18 volts are unregulated. These will go to the drive circuit. It will drive this gate. To drive this gate, we need microcontroller. Microcontroller is connected to the front panel. Here we have 5 volt regulator. These 5 volt are required by this MCU and these are required by this front panel. The problem here, when we don't have these voltage, most of the time in most of the cookers, when there is a power failure, this circuit becomes damaged. This circuit, this power drive, because it is using high current device. So what are the checkpoints where we will find the voltage, how we can find the voltage? Let's start. If you see here, from the same line voltage, we have a full wave rectifier, two diodes. Then these voltage are reaching to this capacitor, that is 450 volt, 47 microfarad capacitor, and it is coming to this offline switcher, Viper 12A, Viper 22A, LNK, TNY, top, any switch, because it is not using any optocoupler for regulation, it is just only switcher. How it works? It will provide these positive voltage here. It is just only buck regulator, step down converter. As a feedback, when this winding will generate magnetic field, at that time it will rectify the voltage and this voltage will reach at this capacitor, that is feedback pin, that is enable pin, pin number 4 in Viper 12A. And here it is using 18 volts between pin 3 and 4. And these voltage are also reaching outside to the circuit. These 18 volts are provided to these transistors here. And it will switch this 18 volt to the IGBT. From the same transformer, same choke, it is not a transformer, we can say it is a choke, because it is a series regulator. The voltage are passing from here to here. It is just only working as a AC resistance. The second winding, it will generate about 9 to 10 volt, 8 volt, and then 78L05 IC will regulate 5 volt for our processor, for our front panel. Similarly, we have another circuit. I will attach the link of these diagrams in the video description. You can download it. You can check for reference. The same here, it is also using offline switcher. It will generate 18 volt and 5 volt. If it is transformer based, if it is buck regulator, it will work the same. We need 18 volt, 15 volt in some circuits that are using 12 volt, high voltage and low voltage. The same voltage will be used for the fan as well. If we check the circuit, line and neutral are provided here. One line is reaching here, the second line from this regulator, from this fuse, the second line is reaching here. We have full wave rectifier at this point. Then these voltage will pass here to this resistor. Okay, after that this voltage will reach here at this capacitor, that is here 400 volts, 4.7 microfarad, 450 volt. This capacitor will charge at that voltage. The ground, it will reach from this point. This is the ground line. It will use ground here and the positive voltage, it will reach here. This voltage will reach to this transformer. Now how it will work? What are the checkpoints now? Now I am applying power. near the IC, either it is using wiper whatsoever. Here it is using zener diode that is very closer to this IC. Now check the voltage across this zener diode. It is 18 volt. This zener must have 18 volt. Let me connect ground to the ground terminal so our one lead will spare, because this circuit is using only one ground. Yes, now ground, I connected the ground. Now we can check voltage here. This line, it is 335 volts. Here 335 volt at this capacitor, that is the large capacitor here inside. And then we have here, we have 9.2 volt. Where is that? Here it is using very small IC, that is voltage regulator 7805, that is closer to this small jack. We must find 5 volt here. This is input 9 volt, center pin is ground, and the output pin, that is 5 volt. How we can find where is the problem? The first step, we have to remove the front panel, because the same 5 volt are going to the front panel, the same voltage are going to this NTC. The NTC that is here, the thermistor here, if this one is damaged, it is a short circuit, it will also cause to drop the voltage. First thing, we need to remove this one and we need to check the voltage in the output side of this regulator. Then we will check the voltage at this connector that is going to this front panel. It have 5 volt positive ground, and the first pin, that is ground pin, the second pin, that is 5 volt. If we have problem in the front panel at that time, if we remove this connector and voltage are stable 5 volt, that means we need to troubleshoot here in the front panel. In the front panel there is a PCB. And LEDs, sometimes this wire is damaged here, some wire is making short circuit with the ground. So we can check front panel if there is a problem in the front panel. The second thing, in some cases this capacitor is bad, and sometime these three capacitors are bad, that are for 18 volt, 9 volt and 5 volt. If any one capacitor will damage, at that time we will face the same problem. And if our this 5 volt regulator is damaged, it will also cause the problem. Sometimes these three transistors here, if these transistors have problem, any one transistor will damage from this, it will cause to pull down this voltage as well, because at that time it will disable the drive, or it will cause to load the 18 volt. This capacitor 334 volt, this capacitor 19 volt, and output of this capacitor is 5 volt. Then one capacitor is here, that is 10 volt, 9 volt, 10 volt. So 9 volt, 18 volt, 5 volt. If any one capacitor is bad, especially 5 volt, so we need to remove one by one components to verify it. Also verify this 7805, because it's 78M05, because its current is very low in milliamperes. If there is something wrong, it will damage immediately. In the circuit, if we see here, we have this diode. After this diode, we have capacitor that is here, 9 volt capacitor. Then we have this 5 volt regulator 7805, and after that we have this capacitor, 5 volt capacitor, that we checked voltage here. If these are making problem, our system will not work properly. Check these three transistors, check this zener and this capacitor, because if you are finding voltage here, some voltage here, that means the IC is switching. No need to check this IC. You can verify this capacitor, that is bypass capacitor here, small one, and one capacitor, 1 microfarad, 50 volt. Check voltage across the zener, it is 18 volt. Voltage across the second resistor, this is 467 millivolt. That's okay. And we have these rectifiers. Check this rectifier, that is in output side. It is 19 volt. That is this one. And another rectifier very closer to this, that is 9 volt. When you are checking the output of the transformer, no need to check the voltage on the capacitors. You will find the voltage across these diodes. These two diodes are output side. If any output is dropped, you can detect it immediately that this circuit is losing the power. 19, 9. These 19 volt are regulated through this zener diode. It is at 18.2 volt. And these 9 volt are regulated from this 5 volt regulator, and it will reach to this NTC, and it will reach to the front panel. Front panel, these two pins, 5 volt regulator. Front panel connection, that is here, these first two pins, 5 volt. So in this way we can detect the problem here. If the NTC is bad at that time, it will give error code. This time the problem, it is not giving enough power to power on this IC, so we need to check these power components. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11, and this voltage regulator, and two diodes here, zener, output rectifiers. So in this way we can detect the problem. Anything short circuit here, it will cause to drop the power. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.